Namaste. Welcome to Tricolor Hospitals FB Life. Today we'll be talking about MICS, also known as minimally invasive cardiac surgery, and how the procedure can help patients recover better and faster. Traditional heart surgery usually requires large incisions followed by a longer stay in the hospital. Compared with open heart surgery, this type of surgery is less painful and ensures a quicker recovery. Dr. Devinder Singh, Chief Cardiothoracic and Vascular Surgeon at Tricolor Hospitals. He is specialist and expert in keyhole surgery, also known as MICS. Dr. Singh will be answering all your questions and doubts, so stay tuned with us. Namaste, sir.
Good evening, everybody.
Yes, sir. So we'll quickly start our session. And my first question is, what is minimally invasive cardiac surgery?
Minimally invasive cardiac surgery is also known as keyhole surgery. So it is one of the variety of the surgery in which the heart operation is done without cutting the bone and through small incisions. So the healing is better and recovery is faster for the patient, and they can return back to work much earlier as compared to the traditional surgery.
Okay, sir. So my second question is, how is coronary heart disease diagnosed?
Yeah, so there are many ways to diagnose a patient having coronary heart disease. First and foremost is that we take a detailed history of the patient. We want to know whether he has got diabetes, whether he has got hypertension, whether he smokes, whether he has got any family history, what is his cholesterol levels, and all the relevant information which may be contributory to the diagnosis. After that, we'll do a physical examination of the patient, and then followed by some basic tests such as the lipid profile, where we check the cholesterol levels and other markers of heart disease. After that, we'll do an ECG and echo to see whether he's had a cardiac event in the past. If that is there, then he goes straight away for an angiography. If that is not there, then we put him on to a treadmill test, where one person is made to run, walk, and then run fast on a machine, and which records an ECG and which tells us whether a patient has got a coronary artery disease. So the final test would be, I would say, is coronary angiography, wherein we inject a dye into these arteries of the heart, where if there is a blockage, the dye will not pass in that particular area, revealing the blockage. So coronary angiography is the final test to reveal coronary artery disease. And it also tells us how many blocks are there in the heart, what are the locations of the block, and what is the percentage of the blocks. And on the basis of this information, we will decide the further course of action or the further treatment plan for the patient.
Right, sir. Sir, so how does MICS treat coronary heart diseases, sir?
So as I said, MICS is a keyhole surgery where we make small incisions. We don't cut the bone in the center of the chest. Actually, the heart lies just below the breast bone, the bone in the center of a chest. If the heart lies below that, so traditionally we have to cut open the bone and then we can access the heart for operation. In this particular form of surgery, we access the heart by going through in the space between the ribs. So actually we cut only the muscles and we make multiple small incisions, and then we are able to perform the surgery. The same bypass which is done by cutting the bone is performed by a different route. We don't access directly, we access from the sides, and the operation is done successfully.
Okay. So sir, who is a candidate for MICS?
If you ask me, any patient and every patient who comes to me is actually evaluated for an MICS operation. Any patient who comes in, we need to undergo certain basic tests to see whether he is a candidate. So we need to see his size of the chest. We need to see the spaces between the ribs. We need to see the quantity of fat present in the chest. And technical issues are also need to be evaluated, such as the types of blocks he had, whether he's got a heart attack currently, or whether he's had a heart attack in the past, what is the function of the heart, and what are the other risk factors involved. So taking into consideration all these possibilities, we are able to come to a conclusion whether the keyhole surgery is the best option for him or the second best option. So as I would say, patients who are very obese, hugely built, or who have got very poorly functioning heart, we generally advise them not to have a keyhole surgery.
Right, sir. So when we are talking about cardiac surgeries and MICS, is MICS different from cardiac surgeries?
MICS is actually a type of cardiac surgery. It is not different. Okay. All the operations which are done traditionally by cutting the bone can be done through the chest wall by going between the ribs. So MICS is a form of cardiac surgery. I would say it is a modern phase of cardiac surgery, and every patient should be aware and should ask his surgeon whether MICS or keyhole surgery is possible for me.
Right, so that was an important point. Sir, next question is, what are the post-treatment precautions of MICS?
After the operation, I would say the recovery is very quick with MICS. Because the bone is not involved, it is only the muscles and the skin that heals. The recovery is very quick. We ask the patient to take care of his bone, that is cleaning it every day with soap and water and applying some antibiotic gel or ointment, and to avoid any infection for next about 2 weeks or so. And he can go about his routine activities. And most of these patients are able to go back to work in about 2 weeks' time. But if you see on a whole, the care is very minimal with MICS operation as compared to traditional surgery.
Right, sir. So, what is the success rate of MICS?
The success rate of MICS is same as cardiac, the routine cardiac surgery. The mortality or the complications depend on the risk factors the individual patient has. Whether he has got diabetes, whether he's got hypertension, whether he's had previous heart attacks, what is the functional status of his heart, whether he's got any kidney disease, whether he's got a thyroid disorder, or whether he's had a stroke in the past. So these are the conditions which will come into account on basis of which we calculate the risk of heart surgery. And that would stand equally good for MICS as well. So what is the risk for routine or traditional cardiac surgery? Same would be the risk for MICS. The risk is definitely not increased, but the benefit improves, or a benefit is much more with MICS. Mute again.
So, sir, we are done with our questions, and we have our viewers. They have certain concerns and questions. So, may I please have the viewer questions?
Yes.
All right. So, Vipin is asking, how long is the recovery after this type of surgery?
It takes about 2 weeks to completely recover from minimally invasive cardiac surgery, as compared to traditional surgery, where it takes about anywhere close to about 6 weeks.
Okay. Samuel is asking, what are the benefits and risks of MICS?
Yeah. MICS gives you tremendous benefits, I would say. First and foremost, it is a small incision in the chest. Secondly, the healing is faster. Recovery is much easier. And patients are able to go back to work much earlier. And obviously, the risk of infection and the blood loss is much less. The risk involved is, I would say, the same as any other cardiac surgery, and which would be less than 5% in most of the cases.
Okay. Harsh Bhavsar is asking, how much pain does one feel during the recovery phase of MICS?
I would rather say the pain is very minimal. Most of the time, it is a dull ache in the region where the incision is given, because as the tissue heals, it will give a sort of a dull feeling and maybe sort of a sensory loss in that area, which may persist for a few days. Pain is very minimal, and we give most of the patients is a simple analgesics to cover up for the dull ache.
Okay. Here you go, Harsh. Sonam Pandey is asking, does the health history raise any special concerns after complications?
Yes, that is a very pertinent question, I would say. All the cardiac surgeries we do, we go into the health history of the patient. What is the past history? Whether patient has had diabetes, whether the diabetes was well controlled, whether he's been smoking and how many cigarettes he's been smoking, whether because of smoking he's had any peripheral vascular disease, whether he's had any stroke in the past, and whether he's had any kidney disease in the past, what is the family history, whether his father or mother had similar issues. So these are the various concerns for a cardiac surgeon in any patient coming in for heart surgery. So obviously all these have got implications on the outcome after cardiac surgery. So that would stand good for minimal invasive cardiac surgery as well. So if you have got any risk factors such as diabetes, hypertension, smoking, type A personality, your lipid is deranged, or your family history is very strong for coronary artery disease, then obviously you are at slightly higher risk as compared to the general population.
Correct, sir. Sir Juhi is asking, is there age restriction or limitation for the surgery?
I would say there are no age restrictions. We've done operated patients as far as 75, 76 years of age. Yes, there would be some limitation. If somebody is morbidly obese, I mean, somebody weighing about 110, 120 kgs, one, or somebody has got multiple comorbidities, yeah, multiple problems, where a traditional surgery would offer a better option for the patients, obviously. So we look into the various other diseases an individual has besides the heart disease to decide finally, you know, whether he would be a fit candidate for MICS.
Okay, Jackson is asking, hello, I have a question. If someone undergoes the surgery, will I be able to drive or resume normal activities for 3 weeks after surgery?
Yes, that's a fantastic question. This is what is the advantage of keyhole surgery. Anybody who undergoes MICS surgery would be able to resume activities anytime after 2 weeks. He would be as fit as he was, say, about 2 or 3 months back. So especially in younger population who are working in IT industry, where it is difficult for them to take time off work, and time is very crucial for them. So I would advise them to undergo MICS so that they can get back to work early. And obviously there would be no physical limitation in use of hands or use of upper limbs. Yes.
Thank you, Jackson. Nasir bhai puch rahe, my father had bypassed surgery a year ago, and how he is diagnosed with blocks again. Will MICS be helpful in this case?
Yes, Nasir bhai, looking into the fact that your father has undergone a surgery a year back, it is not advisable to have a minimal invasive surgery as a second operation or redo operation. Because once the operation is done initially, there are basically adhesions, I would say, which is basically the heart sticks to the various structures which are surrounding the heart, such as the bone and the other organs in the chest. So because of which, it takes time to separate the heart from these other structures and make it accessible for the operation, which is not possible through the MICS. It will definitely need a routine or a conventional surgery to correct his blocks again.
Okay. Sir, I want to ask you one question. अगर शुगर किसी का ज्यादा है और हार्ट सर्जरी हुआ या करना है तो लाइक हाउ शुगर इम्पैक्ट्स दिस सर्जरी सर
diabetes, if it is uncontrolled, it is a bit troublesome in the sense that if your sugar levels are high, you're more prone to infections and kidney diseases. So we always prefer to nicely control the sugar with insulin injections before surgery. But anyway, if somebody has got diabetes, obviously MICS is definitely a better option because the wound is smaller and obviously we are not cutting the bone. So obviously the healing would be better in MICS as compared to the conventional surgery.
Okay, thank you, sir. Sir, Samuel is asking, since it is a newer type of surgery, is it totally evolved, advanced or safe?
See, MICS is an established option in cardiac surgery. And I would say we have been doing it for almost close to a decade now. And in the West, especially in the Europe, it has picked up quite well, actually. So I think there should be no fear regarding MICS, as it is definitely well-established surgery. And we are way beyond the experimentation phase. Yes.
So we are done with our questions. So would you like to give any other information about this?
So I would like to just to remind my viewers that coronary artery disease is basically a disease, a lifestyle disease. So over and above what all I have spoken, I would request viewers to look into the preventive aspects as well. What care needs to be taken for an average individual in the society is that we need to be very particular about the food we eat. We need to consume a lot of fresh vegetables and fruits. Avoid sugary foods. Avoid the processed foods. Secondly, we need to exercise regularly. So an average person needs to walk or run or jog or do a moderate amount of activity at least half an hour every day, at least 5 to 6 days in a week. Then besides that, if somebody has got previous history of, say, diabetes, hypertension and other things, you need to see your doctor on a regular basis so that these things are controlled and they don't shoot up and they don't go to a higher level where control will become difficult later on or it would lead to complications. And lastly, if somebody has got a family history of heart disease, say somebody's father or mother or brother has got, obviously, you need to start the checkups much earlier. We actually advise it to be started at 30 years of age. So you need to have a heart checkup with a cardiologist. You need to get a TMT done at earlier age. And you need to follow up with all your risk factors so that, you know, you don't land up in trouble later on. So that is a general advice I would give to most of my viewers.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. I would request all our viewers, जिनको कोई भी सवाल है, कोई भी कंसर्न है, दे कैन आस्क द क्वेश्चंस इन द कमेंट सेशन, दे कैन पोस्ट योर कंसर्न्स इन द कमेंट सेक्शन एंड वील गेट बैक टू यू शॉर्टली. सर, थैंक यू सो वेरी मच. इट वॉज अ ग्रेट सेशन सर. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर द टाइम सर. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.